Vitae Omnes. Today we're looking at Book 4, Section 32. All right. Doom et Guerrenter. While these things were being done, so talking about the British chieftains conspiring against the Romans. So while these things were happening, the Legion, having, according to custom, all together, adverb, having been sent to forage for grain. This is a supine purpose. All right, having been sent to forage grain, which was called, relative clause, which was called the 7th Legion. Nor, with any suspicion, another adjective absolute, nor with any suspicion, having been thought about, with any suspicion of war having been placed at that time, so with no suspicion of war happening. Okay? Cum clause, when part of the men, so these are part of the Romans, had remained in the fields, and another part, the other part, was going back and forth into the camp. So they're taking grain from the fields and putting it into the camp. AE, this is just AE. Those who were on guard in before the gates of the camp, Castorum, Caesari, always Caesari, announced to Caesar that, and then we have an indirect statement here, that the dust was seen, infinitive, to be greater in that part, okay, was seen to be greater than was accustomed, than what custom brought about, than what custom brought about. So he's saying there was more dust than normal for the amount of people they sent out. So they saw that, they announced to Caesar that the dust seemed to be greater than was accustomed into that part, into which part the legion had journeyed. All right, we have to move it up here. You can always fast forward. Okay. Caesar, id quod erat suspicatus. Now, what we got here is perfect participle deponent, suspicatus here, describing Caesar. All right, often we like to have those participles out front. So Caesar, having suspected, perfect participle of a deponent, having suspected this, which it was, that some, this is part of genitive, some new plan was being adopted or was being conceived, was being adopted by the barbarians. So some new plan was being created by the barbarians. Okay, and what did he do? He used it. He ordered the cohorts which were on guard, which were guarding the camp, to Proficiski, to set out with him into that part, okay? And from the rest of the cohorts, he ordered two cohorts to follow them onto guard. So two other cohorts to go on guard, to replace the cohorts that went out with him. Okay? So he ordered two cohorts from the rest to go onto guard, and the remaining cohorts to be armed, he ordered them, and immediately to follow him, Sesay. And when a little further, cum clause, he had proceeded from camp, so when he proceeded a little further from camp, what did he do? He noticed Suos, his own men, the Romans, pressed. Notice that they were pressed, in another indirect statement, by the enemy, and they were sickly enduring the attack. No attack has been left there, but like this is an adverb from sick. So it's like L-Y, sickly. I say weakly endured the attack. And with the legion having been made dense, so having been thickened, so they're coming together, the people are all coming together. With the legion having been made dense, he saw, noticed, weapons being thrown, passive infinitive, being thrown from all parts. Okay, I'm going to move this up to the last bits. this is how, like, how did the Gauls know that the Romans were going to be in these fields specifically, gathering grain, reaping grain? Well, Caesar tells you. Or because with all the grain from the rest of the parts having been reaped, okay, having been reaped, there was one part, so with all the fields having been reaped, there was one part left, okay, and the enemies, P, perfect participle of the opponent, having suspected that our men, and this is would come to here, all right, suspecting they would come here, they lurked, they hid themselves at night in the forest. Then, what'd they do? Oh, where is the verb? Ah, we have a perfect participle from ad aurior. So that contains our subject. So the Gauls then, having attacked the scattered men, busy in reaping gerund, with their weapons having been put down. Oh, they suddenly attacked. So then the Gauls suddenly attacked the scattered men with the weapons having been put down, and they're busy in reaping. And with a few of the men having been killed, they threw into confusion the remaining Romans, the remaining men in uncertain battle lines. At the same time, they encircled them with horsemen and with chariots. And there we go. Volete omnes linguatina est vita.